Hello and a very warm welcome to Saurav Sir's classes. Today's tutorial will be on, that means we will be solving some questions that has been picked from the year 2017 of the CMI question paper for Mathematics and Computer Science Honours. So having said that, let's get started with the tutorial. So we will start the tutorial with question number 6. The first 5 questions from the section A we have already covered. You can see our previous tutorials. So the question says, consider the following construction in a circle. Choose point ABC on the given circle such that angle ABC is 60 degree. Okay. Draw another circle that is tangential to the chords AB, BC and the original circle. Do the above construction in the unit circle to obtain a circle S1. Repeat the process in S1 to obtain another circle S2. What is the radius of S2? So here I will not actually teach you how to make the circle. That is your homework. Okay. But I will give you a lot of hints and I will definitely give you the answer of the last part. So let's get started. I'll give you complete analysis of what needs to be done, and based on that you will make the drawing. Okay, so let us consider the center O and diameter BD of the unit circle. Okay, now it is easy to determine that, or let me determine that S1, you will mark it like this, passes through D and its center E lies between O and D. So I'm giving you a rough idea or complete idea what you need to do. Just follow the step and make the drawing. Now let R be the radius of S1. So given this, the length of ED is R. Now consider the perpendicular from E to chord BA. Meeting BA in the point F. Then the length EF is all so R, and therefore in the 30-60-90 triangle, which is the BEF termed as, the length of the hypotenuse BE becomes actually 2R. Thus 2 is equal to BD, which is equal to BE plus ED, which is equal to 3R. And from here we will get R is equal to 2 by 3. So by similarity, the radius, which is marked of S2, is 2 by 3 into 2 by 3. And this is nothing but 4 by 9. So 4 by 9 will be the answer of the last part. And given this structure, your job is to frame the diagram. So I hope this short tutorial on CMI was helpful. If yes, then don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, share our videos, and thank you so much for watching.